Bombay High Court today granted lawyer and activist Nikita Jacob protection from arrest for 3 weeks in the case registered by Delhi police in the toolkit case related to the ongoing farmers' protest. Jacob's house was raided by Delhi police on February 11th, after which a non-bailable warrant was issued against her. Jacob has sought transit anticipatory bail for a period of 4 weeks and protection from any coercive action pending the present application. The Congress party today put up a spectacular show in Punjab local body elections. Even as counting proceeded, party had won 6 of the 7 municipal corporations by a little afternoon. These were Moga, Hoshiarpur, Kapurthala, Abohar, Pathankot and Bhatinda. Even BJP's former ally Shiromani Akali Dal managed to win big in the polls. Rejection of the BJP by voters appears to be a direct fallout of the months-long farmers' agitation mainly spearheaded by farmers from Punjab and Haryana. The number of deaths in the bus accident in Madhya Pradesh's Siddhi district has gone up to 49 with the recovery of 2 more bodies this morning. On Tuesday, bodies of 47 people, including 20 women and 2 children, were recovered after the packed private bus skidded off the road and plunged into a water-filled canal in Siddhi. A delegation of foreign envoys arrived in Jammu and Kashmir today for a 2-day visit. Envoys from 24 nations are part of the delegation visiting the Union Territory. The group includes European Union Ambassador Ilko Astuto and envoys of some 10 European countries, including French Ambassador Emmanuel Linen. Envoys and senior diplomats of Bangladesh and countries in Africa, Central Asia and Central America are also part of the group. U.S. President Joe Biden warned on Tuesday that China will pay a price for its human rights abuses while responding to queries at a televised event on the Asian nation's handling of Muslim minorities in its far western region of Xinjiang. Chinese President Xi Jinping has drawn global criticism for holding the minority Uyghur in camps and other human rights abuses. Biden added the United States will reassert its global role in speaking up for the human rights.